So, I pun bagi no Izzuan untuk rekod, just in case. Okay. Okay, tak apa. Susah ni Izzuan. I bagi dekat Ain lah. Boleh Ain, Nurul Ain. Just in case, eh? Kalau I tak rekod, you rekod. Eh? Okay. So, last year. How about last year? If you look, okay, 2019. March 42%, June 39%, September 41%, December 38%. Dia agak okay. But I don't know what happened to this year, 35% dengan 39%. But let's hope that December pasal rate akan naik balik. Okay. Element of surprise, I don't think so. Because now you need to cover all these syllabus. Because CBE, normally you akan dapat around 5 to 10 set. Okay, for the CBE. Sometimes kalau you lucky, you akan dapat sama dengan kawan you. Set yang sama. But of course, that can shuffle a little bit for the MCQ question. Alright? So again, format you dah tahu, ada part A, part B and part C. So how to tackle, how to pass. Okay? My aim actually bukan nak dapat world prize winner. I will aim for 100 pass. That's why I ada high passing rate if compared to other my colleague. Okay? For you to pass, please target section A and section B. 36 out of 60. Sometimes ada lecturer kata you can dapat 50 out of 60. You kena pass juga section A and section B. Okay? Nur Ain Najiha. Nur Ain, saya kasi tak Nur Ain yang seorang lagi. Tengah open camera. Okay. Alright. So section A, section B, kalau you dapat 36 out of 60 pun okay. So, bukankah 36 tu almost half? Yes, 36 dah cukup bagus sebenarnya. If you can obtain more, then okay. If you dapat below than 36, it's hard for you to pass actually. 36, let's set 36. Section C, 20 or 40. We dapat half pun okay. Because sometimes section C tak sure which section C dah akan keluar. Okay, so hi Nur Amila. Okay, I nampak dia with a black background, okay. So, no choice, starting December 2016, you need to study the whole syllabus because now MCQ. Previously, okay, we can see pattern. Oh, exam ni dah tanya ni, so tak perlu study benda ni, tanya benda lain. Okay, so this time around dah keluar benda ni, akan study benda lain. But after CBE, no choice, you need to study the whole syllabus. It's okay. Alright, cuma exam ni dah bagi tahu satu tips. If let's say that topic tested before in FMA. For example, CVP. CVP ada dekat FMA. Do you agree? If ada, so bila dia masuk PM, they will ask you deeper. Meaning they won't ask you CVP single maybe. They will ask you untuk multi-product. For pricing. Pricing FMA tak ada. First time you belajar pricing. So for pricing, they will ask you a basic question. That's the tips. Second, limiting factor. Oh sir, I've learned that before. MA2 limiting factor. FMA also limiting factor. If you learn that one before, so during F5, they will ask you deeper. Meaning that limiting factor for multi-products. So you boleh main-main dekat situ. Alright? So, and another tips, okay, yang I dapat because I went to international conference January in Singapore. Luckily before COVID, untuk exam you, dia akan bagi 10 type of question untuk section C. Which lain-lain approach. Number one, dia akan tanya describe. So, how to answer if describe ni question. Number two, dia akan tanya interpret. Third, dia akan kata outline. Number four, dia suruh you compare. Number five, identify. If identify, look at the question. Tak perlu fikir out of the box. Discuss. Again, just discuss. 7, explain. 8, evaluate. 9, suggest. And 10, justify. So, sebab tu orang feel sebab terlalu banyak bigger question yang PM ni dia bertanya. But actually, okay, semua tu ada teknik dia. Okay, and examiner tanya, why student fail? Okay, for your information, PM ni, please don't think like APM. Selalu student dia agak takut. Oh, PM susah, PM susah. Actually, PM is straightforward from your FMA. If you can pass your FMA, trust me, you can pass your PM. Okay? Just answer the basic question. No thinking, no need to think out of the box because that one later on, APM. For PM, just a simple question. Okay? Second, maybe you poor interpretation of data, and I believe why, because of you not enough time. 3 hours. So, mana cukup 3 hours? I punya soalan je dah 1 hour. Okay, so how to cater that one? So that's why you need to have enough practice. Okay, for UiTM and Intech, as far as I know, they will have 4 exam before you attempt your final exam. PT1, PT2, Mock 1 and Mock 2. So I'm not sure how about KDU in here, okay, KDU, maybe you have Sunway here, KUPTM, other college. So at least you need to attempt 4 questions. What if kalau you fail all the 4 questions? Never mind. Memang soalan tu purposely untuk you fail. At least you dah practice. Okay? Alright? So try to check whether A and B, do you obtain 36 out of 60? And section C, dapat tak at least 20? But I always told my student, try to get at least 24 lah. That one can be 24 out of 60. Okay? Sorry, 24 out of 40. So syllabus changes, as for now, no changes as for now. Okay, for PM. If you look at other paper, selalu banyak syllabus. But this is costing. Apa je nak berubah? If you compare to F7, yes, every year akan ada syllabus. Because
syllabus
will be updated. Okay. Yes, Aisyah?
Kenapa dia dah ributnya?
Okay. Tak ada soalan eh tu? Alright. So, okay. Let's take a look at today. Okay, pricing. So, basically my name is Muhammad Shukri, your lecturer for today class. I'm specialized in cost and finance. So, no worries, I will help and guide you. So, if you have any question, please ask me. So, let's take a look at pricing for today. And I can teach you agak detail. So, please ask me if you have any question. Alright? So let me share my screen. So MA2, FFM, PM, okay. Topic pricing. So basically, okay, this topic, okay, if you look at this one, all profit organization and many non-profit. Meaning, all organizations face the task of setting a price for their product or services. Meaning, this chapter is all about pricing. So, what is the best price for you to charge your customer? Semua dah pernah buat bisnes. Let me, okay, share you, okay, bisnes I pernah buat macam-macam daripada sekolah sampai sekarang. Daripada produk, service, until sekarang pun I tell wife I jual cake. So what's the best price? You can use this chapter, price. The best price for you to charge your customer. So in this chapter, we will be looking at the factor which influence price. Meaning, apa akan influence price to price policy. Okay. But, okay, slowly you kena belajar apa itu demand because you kena tahu PED. What is PED? Okay, later on I akan ajar you. And last kali, you akan belajar profit maximization. Ni adalah benda yang last kali and you kena guna this formula. MC is equals to MR. For pricing, dia akan bagi PA minus BQ. But please bear in mind that, okay, yeah, okay, please bear in mind that for pricing, P ni nak cari the best price. Okay, kenapa dia jadi macam ni? Okay, for MCMR nak cari U. Needs. Yang ni lah student sometimes confused. Oh sir, I baru tahu. Selama ni I tak tahu pun MCMR nak cari units. Oh, I ingat P sama ABQ is MCMR sama. No, P nak cari the price. But MCMR nak cari unit because you need to transfer this unit masuk dalam this Q. Ah, dah belajar last semester baru nampak sini. Alright. So slowly kita akan go to the next part, which is okay, benda ni. Okay. Mana-mana buku akan ada this part. Okay. Ini buat tak boleh tukar warna merah kan? Normally boleh. Sekejap ni. Ah, berokey. Okay, this part, which is macam I from BPP. I'm a certified BPP trainer. BPP from London ajar our lecturer. Okay, so benda ni I ambil from BPP. Doesn't matter whether you take this one, sama ada SCCA, Kaplan or Baker's, you need to have this one. At the end of the syllabus, this one you can check. Oh, I can explain price elasticity. Oh, I know how to derive this equation. Oh, I tak sure MRMC. So this one you can ask your lecturer. Okay, I can evaluate. Okay, I can determine price. I can explain different pricing strategy. Yes, benda ni sangat penting. Please practice from now for all chapter. I think plus minus we have 20 chapter for PM. Sempat ke nak exam? Sempat. Satu chapter 2 hours macam tu dia pun cukup sebenarnya. Okay, please have this one. At the end of this class, I akan check you one by one this note. Okay, please remind me. Alright. So basically, before you learn what is price, what is the demand equation, you need to know this demand equation only will happen or can be used when you have demand and price elasticity. Kalau ada demand and price elasticity, that's why baru you boleh pakai PA minus BQ. So kalau tak ada, sir, in real lah, ada cara lain lah. Tapi for your exam purposes, you need to have this demand and price elasticity before you learn how to charge your customer. P is A minus BQ. That's why in mana-mana buku pun, they will ask you or they will teach you demand and price elasticity first. So basic knowledge, higher the price of good, lower the quantity demand. Yes, contoh macam I jual pen ni. Let's say satu ni I jual ni 10 sen. You suka tak pen dengan harga 10 sen? So when the price is low, okay, oh sorry, price is low, so you akan dapat high demand. Kalau you charge, okay, nampak ni high demand. If let's say you charge this pen for RM20, rasa ada korang nak beli? Tak ada. Kalau ada pun Ain beli sebab Ain sudah Ain. Kesianlah sini tak siapa nak beli pen dia. Mila Ain beli. So Ain seorang beli. Because I charge agak mahal, so maybe ada seorang yang beli. Okay, so this is the basic untuk you belajar this chapter, okay, about demand and price elasticity. Higher the price of good, the lower the quantity demand. So basically, price elasticity is measure the change in the market demand for good in the response to change in price. Formula, adakah dia bagi dekat exam? Tak bagi. So changes in demand ataupun changes in quantity divided by changes in price. Okay, hati-hati dekat sini. Orang selalu confuse yang Hilo method. Y2 minus Y1, S2 minus S1 untuk cari B. Betul tak? Dekat formula this one. This is Hilo method. But this question belum masuk lagi that price. Belum lagi touch this PA minus BQ. This part dia nak check only the elasticity. So be careful, even though PED sudah ambil, oh, kita buatlah changes in price divided by changes in demand. Ikut formula ni. No, salah. Dia terbalik, which is changes in quantity or demand divided by changes in price. Walaupun dia kata PED, jangan ambil P divided by D. You kena terbalik. Only for elasticity. Okay? Meaning, PED, okay, you terbalikkan dia. Changes in demand divided by changes in price. Dia terbalik. Only for elasticity. If let's say more than one, then price is elastic. Less than one, price is inelastic. Okay, inelastic tu maksud dia kalau you naikkan harga pun orang tak kisah. For example, Milo. Tahu Milo? Milo.
Tahu.
Milo cakul tu Milo. Milo, okay. Right? So Milo, kalau you perasan, macam I penggemar tega Milo. Pagi kena Milo. Tapi campurnya sikit-sikit. Malam sudah tidur, kena ada Milo. Petang kena I buat Milo ice. Heavy day. So macam I suka beli Milo, I perasan from last year naik price tu sikit. Sebab I selalu beli. Every week I saya akan beli one tin tu. Sebab family I agak ramai kat rumah, I akan beli one tin. I perasan bila I beli, kenapa harga dia makin naik. Slowly orang tak perasan pun harga dia naik. Kalau orang perasan pun orang tak kisah, I tak apalah. So Milo pun macam kita naikkan harga because people still buy our product. Maksud dia inelastic. Which I agak sedih lah. Kenapalah dia makin naik harga kan? Tak boleh kerana ramai join I mogok dekat Milo tu. So kita cakap dengan dia price elastic. Jangan beli. Tapi tak boleh because orang dah famous dengan Milo. Even mama pun Milo, okay? But elastic, what is elastic? If let's say you naikkan price, then that can affect demand. This is elastic. Okay? Let's say I jual to do RM20 for one shawl, okay? Naikkan RM1, RM21, demand akan fall. Naik RM22, demand akan fall. They want elastic. Okay? Whenever you calculate elastic, sama ada dia positif or negative, doesn't matter. 1.125, dia elastic. A negative 1.125, dia elastic. Examiner kata, jangan kisah pasal positif and negative. This is just, you want to measure the price elasticity, the changes. Okay, as long as more than one, elastic. Less than one is inelastic. So if you rasa cukup basic knowledge in here, let's try this question. Boleh? Try this question. 1 minute. What is the price elasticity between price of 12 and 3? 13. This is answer 1.125, but try calculate. Dapat tak you dapat jawapan dia? I need to set time for only 1 minute because of our time constraint. Okay then. Okay, so basically demand is 800 unit when the price is 12. If the price increase by 1, which is 13, demand will decrease by 75 unit. So how to do this question? You akan buat macam ni. Price 12, demand is 800. But if price increase by 1, sini ya, 1, demand akan jatuh to 725. Agree?
Agree.
Okay. So because ada 75 unit in here, changes. So what you should do, you ambil benda yang you bulat-bulatkan, which is yang tengah-tengah. So changes is 1 dengan 75, but dia kata percentage. So macam mana nak kira ni? You ambil 1 divide by 12. Then, for unit pun sama ikut demand 75 divided by 100. So, changes in quantity demand 75 divided by 800. Okay. For changes in price, 1 divided by 5. Dapat 1.125.
Dapat.
This is teknik yang I nak ajar. Okay. So, kenapa I kena ajar you this technique? Sometimes student confused. Dia ambil 1 divided by 13, 75 divided by 725. That's why kalau you perasan, the way I arrange this part, I will put basic first, 12 dengan 800, and then 13, 75, I ambil the middle ni. 1 divided by 75. And dia akan divide balik the original price. Okay? And original demand. 1 divided by 12, 75 divided by 800. So if you can understand this one, now try to open after this any book, try to answer 2 or 3 price elasticity. If you think yes, I rasa I dah confirm price elasticity, dah okay sir, then baru you move to next part. So as for now, clear for price elasticity?
Clear.
Yeah. Alright. So yeah. If you have any question, just ask. Alright. So next, okay. 4P of marketing mix. Can you explain? Okay. Kenapa I keluarkan benda ni? Okay. Because sometimes soalan akan tanya teori. other than pricing, if you say you want to be a pioneer in that market, you want to sell a product, you want to get a competitive advantage, okay, you need to have a good price, you need to have a good product, okay, you need to have a good place where to buy the product and a good marketing or promotion. Okay, CEO Coca-Cola once told us that Coca-Cola tanpa marketing is just a water and a sugar. Nampak pentingnya marketing. And kalau you rasa the best four ni, 1, 2, 3, 4, I dapat rasakan Apple. Macam I pengguna Android. Okay, so I akan rasa Apple is the best yang ada marketing mix. Because you agree tak? Price dia okay. So tak okay, so price dia mahal. You jangan beli yang high price. Okay, you beli yang low price. Dulu okay lah, but I rasa still manageable price. Malaysia mahal, but you pergilah overseas. Because 999. Macam member I kerja auditor, okay, dekat sana 4,000. Boleh dia beli one Apple product per month 999. Macam I kalau kat Malaysia nak beli Apple 5,000 something, nantilah tunggu bulan depan. Tunggu dah setahun dah. Okay, price. Second, product. I think Apple punya product agak good quality. Sometimes I can see my student use iPhone 5S. Macam, wah, zaman bila ni iPhone 5S, zaman BlackBerry lagi. But still can be used, okay? Second place, you tengok Apple senang nak beli. Online, okay, and banyak Apple store. And last one, good promotion. Now, semua orang tengah famous pasal Apple, tak ada charger. Kan? I think it's a good marketing strategy. Dia reducekan 200. Boleh je dia letak charger and then harga macam dulu. Tapi dia pandai reduce 200, you nak you beli balik 200. Just normal sebenarnya, back to basic. Tapi dia try nak buat Apple famous balik. Okay? Macam I guna OnePlus. Okay? I think price sangat okay, product sangat okay. But place is hard to buy that OnePlus because I can purchase it online. Only online, OnePlus. And I think OnePlus agak bad for the promotion. Sometimes I think student, you pernah pakai OnePlus tak semua? OnePlus tu apa sir? OnePlus tu phone. Dia macam Huawei, Xiaomi tapi OnePlus macam ha OnePlus. Pixel ke sir? No, I can explain balik. Okay? So, marketing mix, okay? Sometimes question akan keluar teori other than price. How to become a pioneer in one certain product? You need to have a good product, a place and also a good promotion. Okay, now after you understand price elasticity, barulah kita masuk the real chapter, real part this chapter, which is PA minus BQ. P ni apa? You nak set the price. Okay, by the way, you dah dapat tak I punya notes ni?
Belum.
Dapat.
Dapat.
Mak, siapa yang belum?
Saya tak ada.
Tak ada eh? Okay, kalau tak ada, I bagi dekat WhatsApp web. You ada tak group, dekat our group?
Ada kot. Dia dapat dekat Gmail. Sekejap saya tengok email.
Sebab ini you boleh contoh-contoh ke, or you can print. Or maybe I try send PDF dekat our chat box.
Boleh sah. Tak ada, saya dah tengok email tak ada. Baru ada.
Ada. Okay. So dapat, right. Okay.
Baru je.
Okay. Alright. So this one I prepare by myself. Cukup sebenarnya untuk you guna untuk this topic. Okay. So demand equation. When demand is linear equation, for the demand curve is equals to P equals to A minus BQ. Okay. P to price. What is the best price for you to charge your customer? P, price. A, price at which demand is zero. Okay, demand you berapa, masa tu price takkan jadi zero. This one you can calculate manually or you can use formula, which is here. Okay, tapi I nasihatkan you for your exam purposes, buat dua-dua. Then you try to compare. Oh, betul tak jawapan dia? Okay, B is high-low method. Still remember high-low method?
Oh, ingat.
Or we call as our gradient. Okay, Q is the quantity. Q ni lah you masukkan. Satu ke, dua ke, tiga ke, tengok soalan. Kalau seribu, seribu. Okay, sometimes soalan dia tak mention berapa banyak Q tu. So, you kena guna MC equals to MR to put this Q. Boleh nampak kan? Oh, sir. Hari ini buat saya tahu MCMR tu untuk cari unit. P cari price. Alright? So, now, let's test one question untuk kira price. Tapi dia bukan, dia tak bagi berapa unit. Sebab tu dia kata determine the demand equation, which is P is equals to A minus BQ. Please find A, please find B. Itulah kita panggil demand equation. If soalan tu tanya, determine the price. If determine the price, then you kena masukkan berapa quantity dia. Then you akan dapat the price. Let's try this question. Current price is 120 and company can sell 600 item. If price increase to 150, only 450 are sold. So, apa you buat? P is equals to A minus BQ. Okay. A tu, I cakap tadi, you can calculate manually. Or you can use this formula. Let's try manually. Let's say price so, 120. Sorry?
Mana lagi accurate? Manually ke ataupun guna formula?
I suggest both. Okay. Sebab nak check you punya jawapan betul tak? Sometimes kita buat careless mistake. Kalau I kata guna manually, I takut bila you guna manually, salah. But if I ask you to use formula, I takut bila use formula, salah pula masuk formula. So use both, then you can compare. Alright? So I try buat dua-dua. 120 and then price increase by 150. What happened? Drop to 450. So kalau price tu increase lagi, 180. So berapa agak-agak demand dia? Dia akan jadi
300.
Okay. Good. Because why? Bila price increase by 30, demand akan lower by 150. If I increase lagi 30, demand akan low 150 jadi 300. Agree? Yang cuba I naikkan lagi price 210. What happened to your demand?
Decrease.
Become
150.
I naikkan lagi 240. Berapa demand you?
Zero.
So this is your A. Because why? Price at which demand is zero. So now, oh, kalau I charge 240, tak ada siapa nak beli barang I. Itu kita panggil A. So you dapat A is 240. Okay? Minus BQ. Okay. Let's try use this formula. Okay, I padam balik. Mana padam reset. Okay. Try to use this formula. You guys dapat tak A? Again, only 1 minute. Sorry, eh? Because time constraint, let's try for 1 minute. So, berapa current price? 120, agree? Current quantity, at current price, berapa current quantity? 600 divided by change in quantity, berapa changes? 150 kan? Okay. Change in price, berapa change in price?
30.
Cuba 120 plus 600 divided by 150 times 30. You get the answer?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Kalau yes, then good. Maksudnya jawapan you betul. P is equals to A minus BQ. P is 240. Okay, B is high-low method. So, you tahu eh? Changes in price. Dia terbalik dengan formula PED tadi. Changes in price divided by changes in quantity. Sebab Y2 minus Y1 divided by X2 minus X1. So, bila you buat high-low method, 150 minus 120 divided by 600 minus 150. Do you get 0.2?
Yes.
Yes.
So this is you punya P. So setakat ni senang tak?
Senang.
Okay. Itu je pricing sebenarnya. First, you need to know what is elasticity. Second, you need to know how to determine the price. Okay. This is the basic part that you need to know. Kalau you rasa, okay, I want to test my knowledge. Try to find two or three questions regarding this price. Try and error banyak kali until you firm, okay, now I okay for this part, price. Okay. If you are okay with it, so dekat sini I ada ajar you. Okay, step 1, step 2, step 3. Step 1, find A, which you can use manually or formula. Find B is high-low method. Last one, check your equation. Just double check. Because sometimes student buat careless mistake, P is equals to A plus BQ. Such a waste. Should be P equals to A minus BQ. Alright? And sometimes student kira dah betul dah. But P is equals to A dia 0.2 minus 240Q. Oh, sayangnya. Careless mistake. Okay? So, now elasticity done. Demand equation done. P. Let's move to the thing. This part. MCMR. Okay. So, bila nak pakai this MCMR? Okay. Whenever you find the word, in order for this company to obtain profit maximizing. Maksudnya, price yang mana you charge, you akan dapat highest profit ever. The word profit maximizing. Okay. Nampak je dekat soalan? Profit maximizing, you use MCMR. But please bear in mind, okay, I told you tadi, okay, MCMR untuk you find your units. Bukan find your price. So, sir, after we have calculated this MCMR units, what should we do? Then you masukkan dekat formula A minus BQ tadi, demand equation, masukkan this unit dekat Q. Then you akan dapat, that is the best price for you to charge your customer in order for you to obtain the highest profit ever. Okay? So again, profit is maximized when MCMR. Right? So, optimal selling price can be determined using equation or yang ni semua tahu, tabulation. Okay. Whenever I do IRIC, I tak tahu kenapa student tak perasan pun ada tabulation. Dia kata, sir, selama ni I belajar only equation. Okay, for your information, 2016 December, first time ever dia keluarkan tabulation part, MCMR. Because you need to know now is CBE. So, examiner akan diguna the Excel. Okay. So, tabulation. Yang ni, oh, so first time I dengar. So, alhamdulillah, if you first time dengar, it's good. Because at least you dah belajar new things today. For those yang, sir, I dah tahu. Then good again, pun bagus, at least you can recap. So, using equation or tabulation. Okay, let's look at equation first. Okay. So, back to your basic, apa itu MC, apa itu MR. Sometimes the problem with student, dia tak faham apa itu MCMR. If you tak faham theory, what is MCMR, how are you going to apply to that question? Again, I help you to put the definition in here. MC is extra cost of producing one extra unit. Let's say, this pen, variable cost is 2. Okay, one unit of pen, variable cost is 2. If I produce another one more unit, berapa dia punya variable cost?
4.
Total akan jadi 4. Tapi untuk one unit is still
2.
Itu maksud dia. Cost of producing one extra unit. So normally, MC is your variable cost. Dah 5 kali exam, bila dia keluarkan MC, terus cari MC is equal to your VC, variable cost. Because MR kena cari. But MC dia akan bagi. Because MR is extra revenue from selling one extra unit. Again, when you have this formula, P is equal to ABQ. MR ni, okay, A minus 2BQ. So kenapa jadi formula macam tu? Okay, because sebab one is one unit. So kan tambah lagi satu unit, dua unit. Sebab tu MR is A minus 2BQ. So kenapa tak 2A juga? Because A tu kan price when demand is zero. So tak ada perubahan lah. Okay, still you tahu price, what amount of price when demand is zero. So MR is equals to A to BQ. If let's say SM tak bagi this format, they only give you P A minus BQ, automatically you can find your MR. A minus 2BQ. And MR is equals to MC. MC ni apa?
Extra cost of producing one extra unit.
Yes, ataupun you punya variable cost.
Variable cost.
So actually VC is equals to A minus 2BQ. Now can you see the correlation? So normally saya akan bagi VC, A kena cari, B kena cari, automatic you can find your Q. Dan senang. After you find your Q, baru you use this formula all over again. PA minus BQ. Right? So, okay. Let's take a look at this question. Soalan ni agak susah. Antara the hardest question ever yang pernah jumpa. Okay. Tengok, from this question, dia bagi you A, B and C. I think I tersalah kot letak E dekat you punya kertas tu, nanti double check balik. Alright. So, A, B and C. So, let's take a look at this one. ABC makes and sells one movie for two different market. Fixed cost are 20,000. Bila you baca, you might wonder, tak pernah pun selama chapter ni kita belajar fixed cost. But every time bila keluar fixed cost, you tahu dia nak cari profit. Back to your basic MA1 during your CAT. Sales minus variable cost, contribution. Agree? Okay. Minus fixed cost, tu kenapa profit. So from here, I think kenapa dia bagi you fixed cost? Because dia suruh you cari profit. Misi soalan cari profit. Itu I punya first assumption. And variable cost is ataupun 40 for one unit. So automatically you know how to find your MC equals to MR. Okay, market one, market two. Let's try to do market one first. Because market one, dia kata P is equals to A minus BQ. A is 55. B is 0.05. Can you help me to find MR?
40.
Eh, MR? Apa formula MR?
MR equals to A tolak 2BQ.
Okay. So, A berapa?
55.
Okay, good. 2B, 2 times 0.05?
0.1. 0.1 Q.
So, dapat this MR?
Dapat.
Bila you dapat, you buat MR is equals to MC. So, MC is equals to MR. MR is 55 minus 0.1 Q. MC tadi berapa?
40.
Nampak? Exam akan bagi. Try cari dekat question tu, dia akan bagi. 40. So, can you find your Q?
Yes.
Berapa Q?
150.
So, dapat 150? Sama tak dengan jawapan saya bagi? 150. This is Q. Because dia kata calculate, you tengok A. Calculate price to charge in market, which is P. And quantity. MR is MC. To produce each month to maximize profit. Nampak? Maximize profit je, you tahu? You guna MR is equals to MC. Now you tahu Q is 150. So, apa you patut buat adalah masukkan dekat formula. P is equals to A minus BQ. Every time when you do MR is equals to MC, bila dapat 150, so A will letak units. Because I cannot you confused. Always put these units. Be systematic, okay? 150 unit. So what you should do now, apa you buat? A is 55 minus, guna balik formula ni. Ingat eh, MR, MC tu untuk cari unit, now nak kira balik price. Price is PA minus BQ, B is 0.05. 105. Q tadi berapa?
150.
So berapa you punya price?
47.5.
Dapat?
47.5.
Senang tak?
Dapat.
Okay, benda ni lah I rasa the reason student
Allah senang.
Sebab dia tak nampak. Dia senang je kalau you faham basic ni. Okay. Now you can try to do other question, cari MRMC. Oh, I dah faham dah. Cuba kita cari. And typically bagi you VC, okay, what you need to find is P and then convert to MRMC. Sometimes examiner dia baik, dia dah tolong you kirakan dia punya MR.
Usually ada tak soalan yang macam dia tak bagi maklumat?
Ni tak ada bagi maklumat ni, tak bagi MR. Macam ni you kena find your MR, 55 minus 0.1 Q.
Dia tak ada
sampai examiner dia bagi you, dia tak bagi, dia bagi you MR. So easy for you lah.
Okay.
Okay. Tak bagi maklumat maksudnya maklumat tu sangatlah sikit. Ini contoh soalan. Dia hanya bagi you variable cost. Satu je dia bagi.
Ah. Oh.
Kita boleh cari.
Boleh.
Macam ni lah tadi.
Okay, okay.
Okay. But some question dia akan bagi banyak information. But as for you punya basic knowledge, kalau you faham apa itu PABQ, apa itu MCMR, enough for you. Right? Tapi sometimes ada examiner, ada tahun yang dia tak bagi langsung P ni. You need to find your own A, you need to find your own B, and then buat this demand equation. From that, baru you buat MCMR. Okay? So, if you okay market 1, let's try market 2. Cari dia punya quantity and cari dia punya price untuk dapatkan profit maximization. Again, only 1 minute ya. Yeah? So MR equals to MC. Dapat tak dia punya units is 400 units?
Dapat.
Okay, kalau you dapat, maksudnya MR MCU sangat bagus. Dah okay lah. Dah boleh ready dah untuk pricing. Okay. Then when you convert into price, dapat tak 120?
Dapat.
Dapat.
Lega I boleh dengar you dapat. Okay. So maksudnya you dah okay lah untuk soalan ni. Okay, do you have any other question before I proceed? No eh? Okay, kalau no, then kita sambung. B. Okay, actually soalan ni soalan 4C, section C. For 12 marks. Okay, tapi bila I ajar you, automatic you can link kalau let's say tanya dekat part B. Kita tahu nak, dia minta apa, MR, MC, price, you dah ready dah. Tanyalah you macam-macam price. Okay, jadi je. Quantity, alah, simple, MRMC, you beli gelak dekat exam hall tu. Okay, B, calculate the maximum total monthly profit. Ah, nampak dah profit. Now, make sense kenapa dia bagi you fixed cost. Betul tak? Sebab apa? Sebab
sales minus
variable cost dapat profit. Eh, sorry, a contribution.
Dapat contribution.
Cost dapat profit. Patutlah dia bagi you fixed cost, maksudnya cari profit. Okay, so what you should do? Settle one by one. For market one, 150 times 47.50. Berapa you punya contribution?
33125.
Okay. Plus dengan 400 times dengan 120.
So, ulang balik, sir.
Okay, first determine you punya contribution dulu.
Okay.
So, ataupun total revenue lah. Okay, total revenue you. Okay. 150 units kan tadi? Kali dengan price untuk 1 unit. So berapa total revenue you? Campur dengan 400 times dengan 120. Berapa total revenue?
Five, one, two, five.
Okay, good. You dapat 55125. So variable cost kita dah incur tadi dekat calculation of our MRMC. Berapa fixed cost?
Fixed cost 20,000.
Fixed cost, okay sekejap eh. Alright. Kita perlu masukkan lah. Okay sekejap. Ada tak kat sini lah boleh? Bagi you nampak. Okay.
Boleh sir.
So sales you 150 times 47.5 plus 400 times 130, you dapat 5525. Betul?
Betul, betul.
So variable cost untuk one unit is 40. Now you ada berapa unit? 400 dengan 150? 550 kan? So 550 cuba times dengan 40.
22,000.
90? 22. 22,000. 22,000. Okay. Dah dapat dah you punya variable cost. Then kira you punya contribution. Fixed cost dah bagi 20,000. So berapa profit you?
Profit 13125.
See? Dapat?
Dapat.
Bye.
Senang tak sebenarnya soalan ni?
Senang.
Macam senang.
Sebenarnya soalan ni adalah one of the hardest question ever yang pernah keluar dekat Pasir. Kalau you ada BBP textbook, okay, sebab I BBP trainer, okay, I ada that BBP textbook, dia dah pernah keluarkan dekat dia punya soal dekat buku tu, okay, you cuba cari. Okay, dah agak panjang jalan kira. Tapi sebenarnya, kalau you ingat balik basic MA1 you, nampak tak? Pernah tak lecture you susun macam ni? You guna balik. Sis dah tahu price. Variable cost, ambil variable cost. Fixed cost dah bagi, cari profit. So dapatlah.
Section berapa you keluar?
I tak sure. Sebab lain buku tahun, lain buku tu. BBP, nanti you double check balik. Sebab I ada BBP textbook dulu. I ada 2018 and 19. But this year, now BBP textbook dia jadi workbook. Okay? So workbook dah lain sikit. Nanti try double check. Ada tak soalan ni dekat BBP textbook? Fokus. Sampai dia 2019, boleh check. Tak silap saya dekat page 144 something. But for 2020, the workbook dah tak ada lagi textbook. Nanti you try double check. Is it ada lagi atau tak? Okay? Tapi kalau tak ada, tak ada masalah. I dah keluarkan benda ni. A, B, C. Cukup dah sebenarnya. Okay? And C. Calculate and comment the changes in total profitability and prices. Okay. Again, you dah calculate, you akan nampak berapa amount. Dia akan beritahu, okay, sekarang profit you dapat 13125. So sebab tu dia kata profit maximization. Kenapa dia kata comment the changes in total profitability and prices? Because soalan dia sebenarnya ada satu lagi one point yang I purposely hilangkan. Currently they charge 50 untuk both market. Maksud dia sales dia, price dia bukan 47 dengan 120. Untuk dua-dua produk, dia charge dengan harga 50. Okay? So, bila dia charge dengan harga 50, so what happen, nanti you boleh kira sebenarnya produk tu make a loss. Okay? As for now, they make a loss and apa akan jadi. So, you akan comment. So, jangan risaulah. Untuk part sini, nanti kita akan tengok one of the past equation, you boleh buat. Cuma I nak tunjuk you, A dengan B ni. Faham tak sebenarnya?
Faham.
How to calculate and how to charge this new profit. Okay? Kalau dia suruh comment, you comment je apa benda yang you dah buat dekat A and B. So, what happen kalau jawapan I A and B salah? Examiner tak akan penalize you punya A and B. A and B dah salah, okay, tak ada masalah. Tapi bila you comment based on A and B, still ada markah dekat situ. Alright. So nanti you try buat, okay. Kalau you free nanti, try buat C ni. Let's say kalau they charge dua-dua price ni dekat 50 each. So you akan pasang profit tu, dia tak dapat profit, dia akan dapat loss. Tak selai 1,500 ke 1,450. Nanti you just double check. And bila dia at loss, and what happened? Okay, so that's why you boleh compare. Oh, patutlah nama dia profit maximization. Because bila I guna charge price dengan 47.5 dengan 120, betul I dapat profit yang sangat tinggi. 13125. Compare kalau I guna 50 untuk dua-dua market. Yeah.
Hmm, macam mana dapat 150 tu? Saya lost sekejap lah tadi.
150 yang ni?
Yang M1 tu.
Okay, because unit, bila unit you guna MC is equals to MR. MR is A minus 2B cube. Agree? Okay. Marginal cost is you punya variable cost. Okay, untuk limo seating, dia dah bagi dah dia punya variable cost. So tak ada isu, 40. So A minus 2BQ, 55 minus, you ambil market 1 dulu eh. Jangan tengok market 2, market 1. 55 minus 0.1Q. Setuju tak? Sebab 0.05 times by 2. So now, tekan calculator, cari Q. Macam matematik lah, 40.
Faham.
Okay, so dapatlah 150 units.
Thank you, sir.
Tapi tolong jangan buat macam ni. I nak you buat 150 units. Biasakan. Sebab dalam exam kadang you akan gelabah sikit because masa kan. Takut you ambil ini sebagai price pula. Okay. Bear in mind that MCMR untuk cari unit. Kenapa nak cari unit? Sebab you nak transfer dekat formula Q ni. PA minus B Q. Q ni in terms of unit. Okay. Then, okay, I dah tunjuk you formula. Okay. Alright. Which is MCMR. Okay. Sekarang ni kalau you compare dengan knowledge you sebelum ni, masih sama ke ataupun is a new things for you? MCMR. Ke baru nampak ni units?
Jadi mudah faham lah.
Nampak kan ni units? Ha, sebelum tu tak tahu apa benda MCMR ni. Sebab tu I kata kuatkan basic. Bila kuat dia punya basic, tanyalah soalan apa benda pun dia boleh jawab. Okay, ingat so, eh, EM ni dia level FMA tau. FMA tu F2 HSA ataupun CAT FMA lah. Okay, PM ni naik sikit je. So jangan burden you punya macam kepala ni rasa macam susah. Dia sebenarnya apa slightly level daripada FMA. Right? Jangan think out of the box sangat because day one nanti dekat APM. Kita akan jumpa dekat APM nanti. Ha, kalau you betul-betul serius nak ambil APM. Nanti masa tu kita akan besarkan lagi scope kita. But as for now, follow je that question.
Okay. Sir?
Yes?
Tadi soalan cakap pasal price, soalan yang first tadi tu, sama ke kalau dia tanya optimum price maksud dia?
Betul.
Okay.
Sebab maximum profit ni maksud dia optimum price yang nak jual. Sebab kalau optimum price you akan dapat high profit, itu maksud dia. Sama.
Okay sir, thank you.
Okay, good question. Never mind. Okay, now let's look at tabulation. Inilah orang tak pernah nampak. Okay, by the way, I tak sini 317, betul kan eh? 31.70. Okay, kenapa tabulation? I tak tahu whether lecturer you ajar atau tak. Because sometimes bila ajar student, sir kenapa macam first time je I dengar. Kalau siapa ada BBP textbook, dia dah pernah jumpa benda ni. Tapi I think Baker's and Kaplan tak ada benda ni.
Kaplan okay. Ada sir, tapi dia aja simple sangat.
Simple sangat?
Nah, saya ambil Kaplan online.
Oh, okay. So basically ada tabulation and dia pernah tanya. So I believe this time around maybe dia akan tanya lagi ikut luck you. Some student dapat MRMC in formula but some student dapat MRMC in tabulation form. Okay, no matter how, okay, basic you still masih sama, which is MR is equals to MC. What is MR?
Marginal revenue.
For one unit. Nampak tak one unit? Okay, I letak for one unit. MC, marginal cost untuk one unit. So this question, okay, soalan dia agak panjang lah sebenarnya. So I dah simplify, soalan ni dia bagi you. Okay. Alright, dia bagi you sales price and dia bagi you average cost 50.4 until 23.2, average cost 72 until 19.8. Okay, I nak you tambah dekat sini, kita tambah sikit. Okay, the total cost of zero output is 60. Okay. Let's say total cost of zero output 60. Okay, apa you kena buat dekat exam adalah produce this table. Kadang-kadang examiner bagi untuk you isi saja. Sometimes tak bagi. So kalau dia tak bagi, you letak price, total revenue, MR. Settle part MR. Then cari total cost, cari MC. You akan nampak profit akan maximize bila MR is equals to MC. Okay, so let's try with me this question. Okay, for the first part, dia dah bagi you price. So what you should do adalah letaklah price untuk each unit. So price untuk satu unit 50.4. Price untuk next unit 47.1. 43.9. Saya bisakan sikit, okay. Then 40.7. 37.7. 34.6. 31.7. 28.8. 25.9. And also 23.2. Untuk price dia senang sebab dia dah bagi. Sales price per unit. You letak. But now ni untuk price per unit. Kalau dia minta total. Untuk satu unit, berapa price dia? Still
50.4.
Kalau untuk 2 unit?
Times 2.
Yes, good. So berapa dia dapat?
Times 94.2.
Yes.
4.2. Then 131.7.
Betul.
Yes.
162.8. 188.5, 207.6, 221.9, 47 kali 7, 49, betul kan?
Betul, betul.
Okay, 230.4, okay, 233.1, and 23.2 times 10, 232. Okay, to total revenue. Okay, apa itu MR? MR untuk one unit, betul tak? Increase in one unit. So basically, berapa marginal revenue untuk one product? So ini tak issue. 50.4. Kalau ni untuk total, 94.2. Untuk one unit berapa? 50.4 satu unit, 94.2 untuk dua unit. Tapi untuk cari marginal berapa?
94.2 tolak 50.4.
Yes, good. Nampak tak dekat sini? Ni 94.2 untuk 2. 50.4 untuk 1. So berapa pertambahan 1 dengan 2 ni? So apa you buat? 94.2 minus 50.4. You akan dapat?
43.8.
Okay. Before I proceed, you guys faham tak? What is MR? Sebetul I kata, fahamkan basic knowledge, increase in revenue for one unit. So nampak tak? Satu unit 50.4, satu unit 43.8. Jadi sebab kalau tambah dua-dua, dapat tak 94.2 total? Faham? What is MR?
Faham, sir.
Then, try untuk third unit. Kalau dua unit, 94.2. Kalau tiga unit, 131.7. So berapa marginal revenue?
37.5.
Okay, good. Very good. 37.5. So double check balik 50.4, 43.8 dengan 37.5, dia tambah 33 akan dapat 131.7. So tu fahamkan apa maksud MR. Bila you faham, senang you nak jawab. Okay, then 37.5, then 31.1, after that 25.7, then 19.1, okay, 14.3, 8.5, 2.7, betul kan?
Betul.
Okay, dia akan dapat 1.1.
Betul, betul.
Okay, marginal revenue. Okay, total cost. Again, Patut letak sini untuk 0 unit. 0 unit akan dapat 60 lah. Okey, tak ada masalah. Negative 60. Alright. So kalau 1 unit, berapa dia punya total cost? Dia dah bagi tadi. Okey, average cost. Okey. Apa you buat adalah, you akan dapat dekat sini 72. Setuju?
Setuju. Okay.
Then you dapat dekat sini average untuk satu unit 40.2. Untuk dua unit, sebab dia minta total, 40.2 times dengan 2, you dapat 80.4.
Betul, betul.
Okay. Nampak tak? Examiner boleh tanya you, dia tak minta, dia tak beritahu cost per unit, dia kata average. So be careful dekat sini. Itu adalah cara untuk buat you confused. Sebab table agak senang, dia akan main-main dekat situ. Okay. So 72, 80.4, you akan dapat 86.4. Okay. Then 92.4. Okay. 20.1 times 5, you akan dapat 100.5. Then 113.4. 127.4. 1440, dia nak dapat 167.4, and dia akan dapat 198.0. Okay, ni adalah untuk total. Now buat macam tadi, cari untuk marginal cost. 60 ke 72, dia akan dapat 12. Betul tak?
Betul.
MR. Okay, now we are doing in terms of, okay, now we are doing for untuk ni cost pula. Okay, apa ni? Okay, so now here 12, you dapat 8.4. Betul?
Betul.
6 kan? Lepas tu you dapat 6.0, 8.1, 12.9, 14.0, 16.6, 23.4, 30.6. Okay, from here, tanpa tengok profit dulu, cuba tengok mana MR is equals to MC. Yang mana dia lebih kurang sama. Dia takkan accurate sebab dia tak pakai formula. Cuba tengok mana lebih agak-agak sama. Dekat ini yang mana?
7.
7.
7. Okay. Dekat sini, you akan pasang dekat unit 7, dekat selling price 31.7, MR is equals to MC. Tapi saya kenapa dia tak accurate sebab kita pakai table. Kalau pakai formula atau pakai graf, dia lebih accurate. Okay. Proven kalau MR is MC, you akan dapat highest profit ever. Okay, nanti kita akan buat. Dah terbukti dekat table. So you tahu jawapan you akan betul kalau sini adalah highest profit ever. Okay, so yang mana base price untuk you guna for this product, you kena pakai 31.7. Jangan jual terlalu mahal, jangan jual terlalu murah. Itu maksud dia. At 31.7, boleh jual 7 unit, kita ada base price. Okay, so again, profit you berapa? You tengok first, negative 60 lah. Kalau 0 kan sebab total cost you. Okay, so kalau 1 unit is 21.6. Betul tak? Sebab revenue is 50.4. Total cost 72, you dapat negative 21.6, betul?
Betul.
So dapat 13.8, ni dengan ni. Then you dapat 45.3, 70.4, 88, 94.2, 94.5, kan? 221.9 minus 127.4. Okay, 86.4, 65.7 and 34.0. Betul tak? Profit akan maximize bila MR is equal MC. So, nampak? Kita boleh tunjuk proof dekat tabulation and we also can prove in formula MR is equal to MC. But formula, of course, you kena derive from A minus BQ and MR is A minus 2BQ. Dua-dua cara boleh. Guna formula or guna table.
Sir, boleh tanya sikit. How you calculate ni? I lost sikit lah. So, I lost kejap abang.
Which one? Which part?
MC punya part. Macam ni you dapat dia punya tu lah. Figure.
MC. Okay, apa itu MC?
Marginal costing.
Okay, untuk?
One unit.
One unit. Okay. Untuk 0 unit dapat 60, betul?
Aha.
1 unit dapat 72.
Oh, the difference.
Yeah, sama macam MR tadi. Sama je basic dia.
Okay.
From here, 80.4. So, 80.4 dengan 72. Berapa incremental ni? Untuk 1 unit. 8.4. So, 86.4 dengan 80.4. Berapa incremental untuk extra 1 unit? Sebab dia kata extra 1 unit. Kalau 2 unit, 80.4. Kalau unit ketiga, 86.4. So, you tahu extra tu adalah 6.0. Clear? Siapa tanya tadi, okey ke?
Alright. Okay.
So, maximize at price 31.7. Okay. So, basically, I dah touch this part. Itu je pricing yang you kena tahu dekat you punya exam. Okay. So, back to square one, double check. You dah reti calculate and explain price elasticity? If you boleh calculate, you boleh explain, then good. Can you derive and manipulate straight line demand equation? Okay, day one, sama macam price elasticity tadi. Can you calculate, okay, demand equation is PABQ lah. Boleh buat PABQ, reti?
InsyaAllah.
MR MC faham? Boleh kira? Calculate? Okay. So, boleh guna tabular and algebraic method?
Boleh.
Boleh. Pricing strategy. Ah, ni teori. Banyak tanya. MCQ boleh, part B boleh, part C pun boleh. Now, let's look at MCQ yang ada tak dekat sini. Okay. So, ada banyak price strategy. Okay, market penetration, market skimming, and we have premium pricing, price discrimination, product until volume discounting. Okay. So, kalau you rajin, buatlah benda ni. Okay. Kalau I boleh buat, you sudah mesti dah, you boleh buat tu tak? So again, you tengok. Normally untuk new product, you will use market penetration or market skimming. What is market penetration? You nak masuk di market. So, dia akan slow, start dengan slow. Harga murah, makin lama, makin mahal. Itu market penetration. You nak tembus pasaran tu. Okay. So, ni kita panggil market penetration. Low price when dia first launch to obtain volume. Okay. Market skimming, dia terus start dengan high price when product is first launch. Kenapa? Dia nak try to recover development cost quickly. Okay, now, boleh tak you bagi tahu I satu example of product guna market penetration?
OnePlus.
OnePlus. Okay, good. Harga dia murah, kan? Start dengan murah, sebenarnya nak try orang, galakkan orang beli phone. Okay? But before that, Huawei. Okay, for information, I dah pakai Huawei for 8 years. Macam I akan tukar untuk 2 tahun lah. Start 2 tahun, tukar. 2 tahun, tukar. Okay, masa first Huawei dulu, dia tak ada kedai. Tak ada marketing pun. Kena beli online macam OnePlus. But slowly bila Huawei dah masuk Malaysia, dah start pakai artis, marketing, dah start ada kedai, dah boleh rental, dah ada macam Apple Store macam tu dekat Huawei, harga dah makin mahal, RM3,000 ke RM4,000. Now P40 kan, RM5,000 something kan. Dia macam, oh mahalnya, okay. Nampak? Makin lama dia makin mahal. But market skimming, which product guna market skimming? Starting terus high price.
Dark.
Okay. Tapi lelaki apa tu dak tak faham. Okey. Belum tahu lagi, tak tahu ada perempuan pakai tudung dak.
Apple okay. Sir, Apple.
Apple.
Apple bin product.
So, bila you faham dia ni, automatik kalau perlu masuk dalam teori 4 marks. Kenapa ada certain product sesuai guna market skimming, so suitable for new, unique and superior product. Maksudnya customer willing to pay the high price. And maybe they short product life cycle. Kalau you belajar life cycle, short je, dia cepat je habis. Sebab tu you kena buat high price supaya you can cover all the cost. Okay? Maybe terlalu banyak cost. You jual dengan harga murah tak mampu nak cover that development cost. Second, barrier to entry is high. Ni market you, you boleh set suka hati high price sebab orang nak masuk susah. Okay. So barrier to entry is high. Kalau barrier to entry is low, orang senang masuk, jangan guna market skimming, guna market penetration. Okay. Contoh, you jual nasi lemak 50 sen. Adakah orang jual 50 sen sekarang? Tak, orang nak masuk pun takut. Sebab kenapa orang Melayu biasalah, kalau jual nasi lemak, you tengok eksklusif, ada 2-3 orang aku jual nasi lemak dekat tempat yang sama sebelah kedai you. Ya, tak santau-santau lah. Okay, dia orang kes lain lah. Okay, let's say barrier to entry is low, so janganlah guna market skimming. Let's say you buat nasi lemak RM5. Tapi barrier to entry is low, orang boleh masuk, orang akan jual RM4.50. So people will choose the other competitor. Okay, so you tahu bila you pakai market skimming, inelastic demand, unknown demand elasticity. Tengok dah, jual lah. Harga setinggi mana pun people akan beli. Okay. Ada satu hari tu, dia keluarkan produk apa tau, I lupa. And masa tu harga sangat tinggi, korang complain kat Twitter. I pun saja buka produk punya site, sold out. Wah, people complain tapi dia sold out. So I tell the inelastic demand, that's why you can use market skimming. Maybe, Vivi Yusof dia pandai, dia hire accountant, dia dah kira, oh elasticity kita less than one. So I tahu, inelastic kita guna market skimming. So kalau you terlalu high elastic, you pakailah market penetration. Okay, now faham? Okay, other than market penetration and market skimming, you have different types of strategy. Second, premium pricing. Ini sama macam market skimming. Cuma market skimming untuk new product, kita start dengan harga tinggi. Premium pricing untuk yang dah established macam iPhone, yes. Tak ada masalah untuk you buat high premium. Okay, sebab you tahu high quality. Then we have price discrimination. Pernah dengar ayat diskriminasi?
Pernah.
Ha, okay, so saya pernah kena diskriminasi. Ha, okay, tak kisahlah, lama sekolah ke apa ke. But, apa maksud dia discrimination? Same product is sold at different market at different price. Discriminate sometimes by age. Contoh, tengok bayang. Kanak-kanak harga lain, ayah harga lain, warga emas harga lain. Okay? Location. Lain tempat, lain harga. Okay? Even kalau you pergi Starbucks pun, you tengok Starbucks dekat KLCC lagi mahal daripada Starbucks dekat tempat lain. McD ke, nampak tak? Sebab price discrimination. Paling obvious kalau you pergi airport.
Pergi Genting.
Mana airport akan lebih mahal. Yes, airport dengan Genting. Lebih kurang kan? And time. Okay, time tu, okay, you tak pernah rasa kot. Zaman I dulu, first time nak guna phone, dulu lah masa I belajar. Okay, dulu Maxis ada macam operasi burung hantu, macam tu lah. Kalau you call daripada pukul 12 sampai 6 pagi AM, dia lagi murah daripada you call daripada pukul 6 pagi ke 12 malam. Dia ada macam lain-lain rate dia. So kalau kita nak gayut dulu, mesti belajar dulu kan. Pukul 12 je boleh kita start gayut, kan, sebab dia murah. Okay? So tu zaman lain lah. Zaman sekarang tak ada kot time-time ni. Apa example yang kalau time ni lebih murah, kalau masa-masa lain dia lebih mahal?
Grab.
Raya.
Grab.
Grab tu juga peak time kan. So, I tak perlu ajar. I faham budak-budak sekarang makin pandai. So, product bundling. Okay, apa itu product bundling? Okay, a group of product sold together at lower price. Contoh macam McDonald's. Okay, you beli value meal lebih murah kalau you beli sekali. Konsep. I pernah jumpa depan I, ada satu budak ni. Kak, I nak fries. Lepas tu, I nak McChicken. Lepas tu, I cook. Orang tu tekan satu-satu tau. Macam I kat belakang dia macam stop, I suruh stop. I beritahu budak ni ambil that set. Sebab budak tak tahu. Even the medication pun mengikutkan je. Harga dia lebih mahal. Maksudnya I belakang tu. Okay. So maybe dia benci I lah kot, sibuk je mamak ni kan. Okay, tapi I nak membantu dia. Okay. Product bundling is much more cheaper. Okay. Second, psychological price. Yang ni suka pakai RM9.99 kita beli murah, RM10 tak payah beli lah. Contoh harga barang tu RM100, you nampak oh dah 3 angka lah. Tapi kalau jual RM99.99, dia belilah. Nampak tak? Price psychological memang normal kat mana-mana orang. Cuba tanya orang perempuan dekat sini, kalau ada 10% discount, pergi Tesco ke Giant, jom beli. Walaupun harga dia lebih kurang je, tapi because ada discount. Yes. Okay. What we call as psychological price. Yang pakai 99 ni ialah dekat 99 lah. Dia banyak pakai. Okay. Tesco, Giant, dia akan punya psychological price. Yes, Shopee. Okay. Eh, ya ke Shopee pakai psychological price?
Banyak.
Yes lah, betul banyak. Okay. Then product line pricing. Assess profitability of product range rather than individual product within it. Okay, maksud dia, dia sold separately. Kalau product bundling, kita akan sold together. Okay. Contoh paling obvious, Samsung. Samsung phone tu. Sebab Samsung offering different smartphone with different feature at different price. Okay, so pricing different product with the same product range at a different price point. So meaning that the greater the features and the benefit obtained, the greater the consumer will pay. Tu maksud dia. Okay. This, okay. So you boleh tengok untuk product line pricing. Contoh lagi satu, product line pricing sesuai untuk macam Johnson & Johnson kan. Okay. Dia sold separately, contoh macam ada shampoo ke, macam tu. Satu produk tapi ada banyak produk range. Shampoo pun ada, then dia ada
lotion,
baby,
ada bedak.
Bedak, okay. Laki, shampoo je dia tahulah. Lotion, moisturizer lah, apa benda semua eh. Okay. Tak tahu baby ada moisturizer ke tak. Tak ada kot, saya rasa. Alright. Then, complementary products. Sometimes, you jumpa ayat dia captive. Complementary dalam buku, ACCA suka guna ayat captive. So, be careful. One sold relatively cheaply, satu lagi dia akan mahal. Contoh macam paling obvious printer.
Huh?
Kalau you tengok printer, okay, macam every printer yang murah, 200 lebih. Tapi toner dia mahal sebab pakai cartridge. While my sister beli yang inkjet, bukan inkjet, dia beli yang laser, 1000 lebih. Tapi bila I compare after 1 year, I beli cartridge tu lagi mahal daripada dia punya total cost. Sebab dia can print for 1000 pages. Tapi kalau pakai cartridge tu only tak sampai 100 pages pun, dia akan habis. Okay, maksud dia one product dia akan jual murah untuk stimulate, satu lagi dia akan jual lebih mahal. Yang suka guna complementary adalah kalau you perasan Tesco ataupun Giant. Sometimes dia buat promo, ada jualan murah, orang pergi. Tapi setiap produk je, dia akan bagi discount. Tapi setiap produk lebih mahal. Kalau macam I sangat kedekut. So, I pakai satu apps ni, I boleh tengok. Barang ni, okay, murah dekat 99. Barang ni, Milo dekat Giant. Ni Tesco.
Trivago.
So, kalau macam rumah I, dia berdepan ni Giant, Tesco dengan 99. Tapi kalau rumah you, ada satu tempat je, then no choice. Okay? And, okay, that one, complimentary. Okay, sama macam loss leader. Okay, lebih kurang. Okay, one item sold at loss untuk promote additional product. Sometimes you tak masuk harga. Macam I pergi 99, harga Maggi cup 99 sen. I kena murah sangat. So bila I beli 99 sen, I pun jalan-jalan dengan anak I, takkan ambil barang lain. Ini barang lain lebih mahal daripada 99, daripada Maggi cup tu. Okay. Loss leader, satu jual produk at loss. Supaya you boleh beri satu lagi produk yang lebih mahal. Okay. And control pricing, kalau you seorang yang power, you monopoly, TM. Dia boleh can set high price. Dia agak monopoly. Astro. I rasa dia monopoly. But now slowly Malaysia dah ada banyak
satu. Dia ada unify.
Slowly lah. Macam rumah I tak masuk lagi TM. Eh bukan time. Macam geram je. I tunggu je time masuk area rumah I. Okay. But now good lah. Kalau you tak pakai unify, at least you ada Maxis Home Fiber. Okay. And last one, volume discounting. Belah bawah ni. Which is bulk discount. Okay. So semua orang akan tahu kalau you beli barang lebih mahal, lebih murah kalau you beli lebih banyak. Volume discounting or what we call as bulk discounting. Okay. As for now, clear?
Clear.
Clear.
Okay. So kalau you rasa you clear, I nak test you sikit lah.
Boleh.
Test you this question. Cuba try number 20. Again, 1 minute. Jangan lama-lama. Okay, I set time sekejap. Okay, okay. Cuba try. Okay, another 20 seconds. Okay, time's up. So what's the answer for number one?
A.
A, sir.
Yes, very good, A. Okay, because market penetration, before you answer, normally, I will tell my student, please read the requirement twice. Tolong baca dua kali sebab nak elak careless mistake. Dia sangat, my student start senyum dah, oh, dah teringat masa zaman CAT. So, saya kata, please read the requirement twice. Okay, now, penetration. Where's penetration? Maksudnya, you start with a?
Low price.
Slowly, lama-lama, you naikkan price. Okay. So, bagus kalau demand tu inelastic ke elastic?
Elastic.
Kalau dia inelastic, you pakailah terus market skimming. People doesn't care about that price. Okay, so kalau elastic baru betul. So bila number one dah salah, I nak you belajar potong macam ni. It's bila nak tembak pun senang untuk you tembak antara A, B and D. So number two, there are significant economy of scale. Apa tu economy of scale? Maksudnya maybe you ada kilang, you can produce a lot of product with a lower price, lower cost, economy of scale. Maksudnya you gain competitive advantages kat situ. So yes, the firm wish to discourage a new entrance. You jual dengan sangat murah, betul ke? You akan galakkan orang supaya tak masuk you punya market.
Betul.
Okay. Number four, product life cycle is short. Kalau short, kita akan pakai?
Market skimming.
Sebab nak cover dengan cepat, so we will use market skimming. So number four salah, you potong, tinggallah jawapannya A. Okay, clear? So good. Yeah. Basic knowledge untuk market penetration. Now I nak try B pula. I try number two. By the way, ini semua soalan CCA. I dah tak pakai lagi buku-buku sebab I rasa your standard now, better you try terus the real example of SCCA. You nampak pattern SCCA. So ni semua soalan SCCA. So let's try number two. First answer for number two. Okay, sekejap. Okay. Another 50 second. Okay, time's up. So, what is your answer for number two?
A.
Setuju ke semua orang A?
Tujuh.
Jom I double check. Okay. In market A, initial charging low price as to gain rapid market share while demand is elastic. So, low price is market
penetration.
B, C, D salah. Dah jangan buang masa. Okay. Sebab ini saja market pressure. Yang B, you tahulah, dia adalah high price. So, dia adalah market skimming. Okay. So, good. Number two. Then, let's try this question pula. Okay. I try. Curi sikit. 30 second je. Okay, what's your answer for number 40?
Both true.
D.
Both is true. So dah nampak eh? Kalau you perasan apa tak? Sisi suka tanya benda yang sama. Kita pun tanya tadi economy of skill. Tanya lagi tahun yang seterusnya. Sebab kadang orang tak tahu apa itu economy of skill. Itu kalau you start buat banyak soalan CCA, you akan slowly akan nampak, oh ni pattern dia. Okay? Good. Okay, datang lah tanya benda teori. Eh, tanya-tanya MCQ. Let's try look at one very, very good example. 15 marks. Okay? Dia boleh tanya dekat part C atau boleh tanya dekat part B. Okay? Let's assume ni soalan part C.
Part C.
Okay? So, kita try buat A dengan B dahulu. So, okay? Without wasting our time, I baca dengan you. Before you answer this question, apa sepatutnya you buat?
Baca requirement.
Yes, always look for requirement. Please remember you ada 3 hours. So kalau you start baca daripada atas sampai bawah, nanti bila you baca requirement, dah lupa balik. So you kena baca balik. So don't waste your time. What you should do, you straight away look at the requirement. A kata calculate, B kata calculate. Okay, maksud dia ada involve calculation lah. And tengok A, dia minta total variable cost per unit and total fixed overhead. Okay, ni senang, ni macam MA1. Minta variable cost, minta fixed cost. So maybe pakai hello method, I tak tahu. Okay, B pula, calculate the optimum profit maximizing. Bila nampak profit maximizing, what you should do?
MC equal to MR.
MC equals to MR. And calculate the profit. So nampak tak ada profit? Oh, now make sense kenapa dia bagi you fixed cost.
Make sense.
So, dia bagi PABX, MRA, 2BX. Kalau dia tak bagi pun, alah, I dah tahu dah. You boleh liquid soalan ni. I boleh ingat sendiri. Ha, cakap SMA tak perlu bagi. Cakap SCA. So, dia dah power dah sekarang dah boleh ingat. Okay, P is A minus BQ atau BX. MR is A minus 2BX. But, jangan lupa MR is equals to MC. And then make sense. Patutlah dia minta variable cost per unit. Because you kena transfer MC is equals your variable.
Variable cost.
Cost. Okay. So now let's take a look at this question. ALG Co is launching a new innovative product. So you nampak a new innovative product into the market is trying to decide on the right launch price. Sebab tu topik ini topik pricing. You want to know the best price to charge to your customer. The product expected life is 3 years. So short life cycle. 3 years je. So maybe that lah phone. I don't know. Given the high level of cost which have been incurred in developing the product, ALG Co wants to ensure that it set its price at the right level and therefore consulted a market research company to help it to do this. So automatic you boleh buang. Tak ada kena-mengena pun dengan soalan ni. Okay. Dia nak menyedapkan ayat. So, nothing there. Nothing information yang diperlukan. The research which relates to similar but not identical product launched by other company reveal that at the price is T, demand akan 25,000. So, kalau this is T, demand is 250,000 units. Every increase to in selling price, maksudnya kalau CC2, demand akan jatuh by 2,000. Meaning that dia kena di 248,000. So you can kira manually. So dia lambatlah sikit nak kira manually. Okay. Ataupun no choice, you kena kira by formula. Even I, kalau I ada banyak masa, I akan patah balik, I akan kira manually. Buatlah slow-slow. 64 dapat 246. Lambatlah. Sangat lambat. Okay. So then, alright. A forecast of the annual production cost which will be incurred by ALG Co in relation to the new product are as follow. Okay, now dia bagi annual production 200, 250, 300, 350. Dia bagi you direct material, direct labor dengan overhead. So you kena double check. Betul tak this direct material variable cost, direct labor variable cost, overhead to variable cost? So you try one by one. Direct material 240,000. Divide by 200,000, berapa you dapat?
12,000.
12,000?
cost dia adalah 12. So normally direct material is variable cost sebab direct. Okay, but you double check. Tu tak 4200 divide by 3500 dapat tak 12?
Dapat.
Dapat sir.
Okay, sebab if you remember you punya basic MA1, variable cost, total cost akan macam ni. Okay, tapi kalau variable cost untuk okay, untuk per unit dia akan constant. Okay, variable cost per unit. So you tahu sini 12. Okay, so I tak ada masalah dekat direct material. Direct labor 1200 divided by 200?
6.
So check ni, betul tak? 6.
Betul.
Kau dapat 6?
Betul, sir.
Hai, kalau semua variable cost, bila masa you nak cari you punya fixed cost? Then try tengok overhead. 1400 dapat tak? Divide by 200 sama tak dengan 1850 divide by 3500?
Tak.
Tak. So total cost tak sama, variable cost per unit pun tak sama. So you tahu dalam this overhead ada fixed cost and ada variable cost. Now try to recap your CAT. Which method or what method yang boleh divide into variable cost and fixed cost?
High-low method.
High-low method je yang you boleh separate between variable cost and fixed cost. So bila you dah asingkan, can you please help me to do A and B? So 3 markah dengan 7 markah. Berapa minit? 10 markah berapa minit selalunya?
3 minit.
1.8.
3 minit untuk duduk soalan ni?
No.
Tak. 5.
5 minit? 10 markah?
10.
Okay, normally 1 marks 1.8 lah. So 7 dengan 3 akan dapat around 20 minutes. Tapi you guys are my student. My student kan selalu pandai-pandai macam korang semua. Let's take only 10 minutes. 10 marks, 10 minutes. Can you please help me to do A and B? Okay, 10 minutes ya. Yeah? So I reset balik sekejap. Okay. A and B. I dah try bagi dekat our group chat just in case kalau you nak soalan ni, okay? But this one in terms of image, format dia PNG. I terbagi dekat Najiha sahaja. Okay. Nampak tak dekat our group chat?
Nampak.
Okay, they want to ALG, ni untuk MCQ. Just in case kalau you nak buat balik. Okay. Okay, you have another 2 more minutes. Okay, time's up. Okay, please let me know what's your answer for A, variable cost.
Twenty-one.
Very good. Variable cost 21. Fixed overhead.
800,000.
Okay, well done. Fixed overhead is 800,000. So kalau you suruh kira optimum production, optimum ataupun optimum profit maximizing, PABX, berapa P, okay, sekejap eh, PABX atau Q, A berapa you dapat?
60
ke A?
310.
60 tu kalau demand dia 250, A kan kalau demand dia 0. So, you akan dapat A to 310. You pakai
yes.
Formula. Okay? Macam I degil. I nak pakai manually. Okay? So, apa I buat? 60, 250. So, berapa price I akan dapat 0? Berapa increase of price? So, I buat, kalau I naik by 2, dia akan jatuh to 48. So, apa I buat 250 divide by 2000, which is 125 kali ganda, betul tak? 2000 kali dengan 125 akan dapat 255,000. So, increase this price is 2. So, I buatlah 2 kali 125, I akan dapat 250. Plus dengan 60, I akan dapat 310. So, I kira manually. Ataupun kalau you rajin, you buatlah 60, 62, 64, 66, 68, 70 sampai dapat 0. Okay? Yes. Tapi I nak double check, betul tak 310? You punya A. So, bila I kira guna formula, I dapat 310. I pakai manually pun 310. Okay? So, P is A minus BQ. AU 310. BU berapa?
I dapat 0.001.
Betul. 0.001 Q. So, bila you nak masukkan dekat MRMC, apa you buat? 3P A minus BQ. MR is A minus 2 BQ. So 0.001 kali dengan 2 you akan dapat 0.002 lah kan. So
yes.
MR is equals to MC. A minus 0.02Q. So saya sambung sini ya. So MCU berapa tadi?
21.
Automatik you akan dapat QU berapa?
144,500 units.
Okay, always tulis units. Tolong biasakan. So you dapat 144,500 units. So you akan dapat 3 markah dekat sini, you akan dapat 3 markah dekat sini. Tapi sini kan 7, mana datang lagi 4? Dia suruh calculate profit. Okay, so let me share my screen. Okay, I stop share dekat sini. Macam mana nak present dekat exam nanti for your final exam? Again, be systematic. Anggap exam itu macam tak pernah ambil ACCA. Okay, so you tengok cara I present. Okay, boleh nampak? This one I present variable cost and fixed overhead. Okay, yang ni I present untuk PA minus BX 60. 10 and 10. Tapi I tunjuk dekat examiner, how do I obtain B? Dia akan klik dekat sini. Perlu tak you tunjuk formula? Tak perlu. Bila dia double click, dia akan appear formula. Examiner akan bagi markah based on you punya formula. Sometimes dia akan tengok dekat sini. Nampak ni? Formula chart ni. Okay? So again, semua dapat dekat sini. Right? So, bila you tahu units, masukkan dekat formula PABQ, dapat tak price dia 165.5?
Dapat.
For your information, kalau you boleh jawab this ALG, you can answer mostly semua soalan dekat pricing. Because why? Ni antara soalan paling susah examiner pernah keluarkan. Kenapa paling susah? Because dia tak bagi you variable cost. You kena cari highly method. Itu satu masalah. Second, you kena cari one by one. P kena cari, MR kena cari, rumus semua you kena cari. A kena cari, B kena cari. Okay, selainnya dia akan bagi A berapa, B berapa. Even A ni pun susah nak kira manually. Alright, so bila dapat 165.5 baru kira profit. Yang ni ada jayu tadi eh. Sales revenue, apa you buat, you ambil lah profit ni kali dengan total number of unit. Macam I pakai formula, bila examiner klik je dekat sini, dia akan appear. Oh, I ambil from here and ambil from 144,500. If let's say jawapan you salah benda ni. 16.5 you salah, 144,500 pun you salah. Teruskan je. Ada markah dekat sales revenue. Examiner will depend on your answer. Okay? Variable overhead. So senang eh. You ambil 144,500 times 21 minus fixed cost. Dapatlah 20,080. Dia bukan minta contribution. If contribution, sales minus variable overhead. But this question ask for profit. Semua dapat 20,080,250.
Dapat
ke? Dapat, sir.
Kalau you dapat, automatic you akan dapat 10 marks. Free 10 marks. Okay. So, apa tak balik soalan ni? Okay. Saya nak stop share dengan laptop ni kejap eh. Nak cari je. Oh ni, okay. Alright. So, hati-hati dengan soalan. Kenapa hati-hati dengan soalan? If you look at PM. Okay. Look at this question. Dia pecah dua. N. Nampak tak? Sebab tu dia 7 markah. Selalu student akan panik, 7 marks banyaknya. Bila you pecahkan, you akan nampak, oh sini 3 marks, sini 4 marks. Oh sini 4 marks dengan 3 marks. So you can imagine macam mana markah untuk 3 markah. Adakah panjang? Tak. You kena tahu dia adalah level FME. Sebab tu I kata kalau you boleh jawab FME, you can answer PM. Even here 3 marks, saya takutlah 3 marks. But you derive. Variables dengan fixed overhead. Okay, tak ada masalah. Oh, satu markah je. So, boleh buat. Variable cost pun 2 marks. Ataupun here 1 mark, sini 2 marks. Okay, senang. And look at this one. See. that the sales director is unconvinced that the sales price calculated in B. Kenapa dia kata calculated in B? Sebab tak kisah jawapan you betul atau salah. Any answer yang you buat A dengan B akan effect C. So, tak kisah, alright? Above is the right one to charge on the initial launch of the product. So, normally initial kita akan pakai dua teknik. What is the two technique for initial product?
Penetration or skimming.
Penetration of skimming. Very good. He believes that high price should be charged at the launch so that those customer prepared to pay a high price for the product can be skimmed off. Maksudnya price skimming. You tengok 5 marks, tulakkan apa ini? Allah. 5 marks, 5 points. Please remember that. Sometimes ada soalan yang 1.5 marks, sometimes 2 marks. Tapi I will set in my students' mind, 1 marks, 1 mark, 1 point. So ada 5 points. Dia pun fikir, oh, apa ni 5 points? Tapi when you look at the requirement, discuss the condition which will make market skimming a more suitable pricing strategy for LG and recommend whether LG should adopt this approach. Kenapa tak ada dua soalan? Satu discuss, satu recommend. When you derive this part, discuss, you tahu dah kan 3 markah atau recommend 2 markah ataupun vice versa. Okay, discuss can be 2 marks, recommend 2 marks. So, automatic bila you nak jawab dekat final, please put here. Discuss, then jawab jawapan you. Recommend, jawapan you. Sebab sometimes kalau you terlalu fokus dekat discuss, you bagi 5-6 jawapan, dia akan max dekat 3 marks. Bila ayat recommend keluar, there is no right or wrong answer. You can recommend whether you want to use penetration or market skimming. Examiner akan bagi free 2 marks. So again, please set in your mind that this is ini nampak jadi 15 markah. But when you belajar how to tackle the question, ada teknik, it actually quite easy. So basically, okay, discuss the condition. Apa you rasa sesuai untuk market skimming?
This inelastic demand.
Okay, bila you tengok, first the inelastic. Second, maybe short life cycle. Okay, yes. But whenever, bila you jawab general, dia akan hilang markah. Because why? You kena masukkan dekat ALG. Mana-mana soalan, examiner kata you akan hilang markah bila you jawab general. For example, product short life cycle, barrier entry is high. So it's wrong. You kena masukkan for ALG. So you tengok dekat atas, you rasa susah ke tak? First tengok, 3 years. Kalau 3 years susah ke tak? Product tu innovative. Dia masukkan. Okay. And then you beritahu. Okay. Dia elastik ke tak elastik? So bila you tengok based on this, oh dia elastik. So you tahu 3 point dekat sini, kenapa you rasa market skimming sesuai? First maybe you kena letak, for example, dia inelastic for ALG because price dia hanya, kalau you increase 2, reduce by only 2,000. For example. Second, you beritahu the product short life cycle. 3 years. Third, you beritahu this is new product and the innovative product. But make sure you masukkan ayat ALG in every sentence that you create. So examiner akan nampak, oh, you incurred that scenario to your answer.
Sir.
Yes.
How long is a short life cycle? Short span. A short product life.
There's no right or wrong. Contoh macam there's no how to say. We tak set yang whether short tu berapa, long tu berapa. So you kena pandai-pandai depend on industry. For example, kalau phone industry, let's say mobile industry, 2 years I rasa okay lah tu sebenarnya kan. 5 years I dah kira long. So they depend on industry. So right. Macam ni, dia tak beritahu pun ni produk apa. So 3 years basically, kalau I buat business, you say 3 years tu cukup ke panjang ke pendek?
Yang basically, yeah. Yang biasa kata yang less than 1 year is considered a short term is decision making. Is it?
Huh? 1 year?
Yang there's this one thing yang dia kata when it is less than 1 year, then it's considered as short term. But I forgot, is this decision making or this product life cycle? This, I don't know.
Oh, okay. Aha. Itu untuk life cycle. Okay. Kalau 1 year, okay. Some business, 1 year, yes, kita consider the short. More than 1 year, long. Tapi sometimes, kalau you buat business, takkan you nak survive only for 3 years, betul tak? Kalau boleh, you panjangkan that life cycle. For example, MyV. Tahu MyV Pro 2? Okay, you tengok MyV. Dah 10 tahun dah. You tengok dia punya life cycle. Still ada lagi. Dipanjangkan dia punya life cycle. So now dekat sini, you can assume whether it is short or it is long. It depend on you. Sebab tu examiner akan tengok dekat sini. Kalau dia kata ni market skimming, so you kena support yang ni adalah short life cycle. Sebab tu you prefer guna market skimming. Macam tu. Okay?
Thank you, sir.
Alright. So discuss. So any discussion akan ada markah. There's no right or wrong answer. Please remember that. Discuss. There's no discuss. You letaklah any point, examiner akan bagi free marks. As long as you masukkan ALG. Jangan tiba-tiba you masukkan, there is a high barrier entry. I think the examiner tak pernah pun bagi tahu pasal barrier. Betul tak?
Betul.
ALG. So please include your answer depend on ALG scenario. And lastly, recommend. You nak buat skimming or penetration. So you just give me any recommendation, you akan dapat free marks. You beritahu, I prefer penetration because blah blah blah. I prefer market skimming because blah blah blah. Dia dapat free 2 marks. Then automatically you akan dapat 15. Okay, tolong jangan tinggal sebab 3 dengan 7, I tahu dah sangat bagus. 10 out of 15. But please try to obtain high mark as possible. If let's say you tak sure discuss pun, at least you jawablah recommendation. Dapat 2. Okay, what? 12 out of 15. Dah 80%. Okay?
Okay, sir.
So, ni antara soalan paling susah, pricing, yang kita pernah jumpa. But now, if you have free time, you boleh baca lah. Okay? Or you can do another price punya soalan lain. Okay? So, before we end our class for today, okay? So, nanti jangan lupa double check whether you dah cover tak semua part dekat pricing. Kalau you dah cover and you feel comfortable, then you can continue untuk jawab soalan pricing. And kalau you nampak, you ada around 20 topics for PM. Imagine kalau satu topik you buat dengan I macam ni, 2 hours. So, cukup sebenarnya kalau untuk you pass you punya exam. 2 hours. Okay? So, before we end our session, is there any question? Clear ke?
Clear.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Clear. Okay, let's say, okay, those yang dah join I punya IRC, then shouldn't be any issue. Those yang baru nak join, you can use my code, okay, which is referral code Shukri15. You can ask for Timba punya admin, okay? You akan dapat discount RM15 lah. Okay, sebab I dah jadi pricing, you akan dapat discount. Okay, so before we end our class, boleh tak semua, kalau perempuan sorry kena pakai tudung ke kalau you nak, sebab I nak tangkap gambar, boleh tak ramai-ramai? Okay, kenangan lah untuk I.
Kamera rosak.
Ah, tak apa, kamera rosak tu Jia tak apa eh. Jia buka je sound. I stop. Okay, so boleh tak semua orang turn on your camera? Boleh tak I tangkap gambar semua orang? Okay. Oh, I kena divide into 2 sebab kelas ni ramai. We have 37. Okay. So, alright. So, first one. Okay. Mal. Okay, second one. Okay, 1, 2. Smile. Okay, thank you guys for your time. Don't worry, your RM5 kita akan donate dekat charity. And if you have any question, you can just WhatsApp I. You can ask any question. So, that's all from me. Thank you for your time. Assalamualaikum.
Waalaikumsalam.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, welcome.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, welcome.
Yeah.
Yes?
Ni boleh tengok balik ke tak? Tak boleh.
Ada, recorded.
Alright, kat mana ah, mana puan,
nanti you boleh tanya Timba sebab dia dekat website Timba. Okay.
Alright. Saya nak tanya, ini saya first time belajar dengan sir and also already enroll for the IRC.
Alright, Azad, okay.
Yang macam I kena prepare before start the IRC class?
No need. Everything I will prepare for you. If you perasan, I can prepare your own material and you perlu, you first time yang ambil PM?
First time ambil PM.
Bayrat, you dah cover all syllabus kan? Lecture you dah cover kan?
Ya, yeah, dah cover tapi I rasa laju sangat sebab 3 bulan je.
Oh, okay. Tak apa. So, nanti I punya IRC, I akan start all over again. I akan buat semua chapter.
Okay.
Cuma IRC tu dia akan lebih laju lah. Like this one, one chapter for 2 hours kan? Nanti maybe the IRC one chapter for 1 hour 15 minutes. So maybe I akan cakap guna gear 5 lah, laju sikit.
So kiranya untuk join IRC ni, benda at least I memang kena dah ada knowledge tu dah. Jadi tinggalkan revise balik dan buat soalan lah during the IRC.
Yes, tapi basically I akan ajar you balik semua. I akan assume yang knowledge you zero. Don't worry. Macam tadi lah pricing. Kalau you nampak, I ajar you daripada elastik ke tak? Sampai MRMC. So at least you dah clear. You nampak apa yang you tak faham and you can ask me a lot of questions sebenarnya.
Sebab during my online class before this, dia mostly kalau topik yang dia kata kena study sendiri tu yang macam serabut sikit lah. That's why quite okay lah this one.
Sebab macam pricing, selalunya lecturer akan suruh study sendiri. Tapi pricing nampak senang. Cuma kalau you tak faham basic, macam nak jawab soalan tu, betul tak? Okay. Kalau basic you strong, bagilah any question pun you can answer that, that part lah sebenarnya. Okay?
Okay, okay so lah. Thank you. Okay.
Thank you semua.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Okay. Boleh. Syahir nak tengok jawapan B. Syahir ni student I ke? Bukan eh? Okay. Sekejap jawapan B. Profit tadi. I share my screen. This one eh? Okay, nampak Syahir? Sama ke jawapan you dengan I? Okay, kalau you tengok kenapa dia hanya 3 markah sebab piece of it dia akan bagi 1 je. Okay, ataupun 0.5 sebab dia dah bagi dekat A. Sales revenue dengan variable of it akan dapat 0.5. Dia dapatlah 2 or all ataupun 3 mark. Macam tu lah examiner akan tanda. Tapi let's say kalau ni semua salah, sebab atas semua salah, still akan dapat full mark. Sebab dia akan depend on your answer dekat A dengan B. So no worries.
Okay, sir. Okay? Sir?
Yes.
Apa nak tanya dia? Allah, lupa nak tanya apa.
Tak apa. If you have question, hit me dekat Twitter pun boleh.
Oh ni tak. Kan tadi saya cakap pasal group kan?
Okay.
Group WhatsApp. Saya tak rapat pun pasal info tu.
You ada masuk IRCI tak?
Oh, dia kena masuk IRC dulu lah.
I tak sure dalam group ni untuk IRC saja atau untuk untuk refresh class sebab I baru join, dia baru masukkan I. Sebab tak silap I, dalam ni ada 17 orang saja. Nanti just double confirm balik. Tapi kalau you nak this recorded video, nanti Timba akan provide to you.
Okay, just email dia orang.
Yes?
Thank you, sir.
Okay, welcome.